Good luck.
Fort Fritz, your one stop for news, current events, and all forms of entertainment relating to the paranormal, the supernatural, the Fortean, and things that go whoo, bump in the night, all packaged and presented in the form of know-nothing know-it-alls entertaining the unknown. Hello, I am your host, Fritz, joined as always by co-host Mandaddy.
Hi.
Angela.
Hello.
And Kaz.
Howdy.
Well, this is really, really exciting. We recently got the opportunity to check out Halloween Horror Nights.
Yeah.
So much fun.
Right?
Always
love
good.
It.
Always a great
always
time.
Always the best.
How many turkey legs did Kaz and Mandaddy eat collectively?
Four each.
Collectively.
So eight total.
There you go. Thank you. Thank you, Angela. Halloween
four
Horror
turkeys
Nights.
Worth.
I think they shared the last one. It was cute.
Yeah, it was one whole turkey.
It was like a Lady in the Tramp.
Yeah. Right in the middle.
Yeah, it was weird.
Halloween Horror Nights is a Central Florida tradition. It is the great bastion of what a theme park can be. And it all started how many years ago, do you think?
Ooh, well over 20.
Close to 30. I don't think 30 yet, though.
Six
years ago, right. Kaz, or 26?
I think that's when I hit it. Yeah, 6 years ago.
So Kaz, six years ago.
It didn't
ago,
start until Kaz
didn't
showed
start
up.
It
Kaz doesn't exist in my universe
until Kaz has seen it.
Halloween Horror Nights started off right here in Central Florida, our own backyard. I thought that was the most amazing factoid.
So it started here and not in L.A.?
Yeah, yep. Right here in Central Florida.
Cool.
In O-Town.
And it was actually 27 years ago. October 25th, 1991.
Oh, my
wow.
gosh.
And it was just 91. Called Fright Nights.
Nice.
It was called Fright Nights.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
So does anyone remember the old billboards back in the day?
Well, they used to advertise a different character. They used to always have different characters that hosted each year.
Yeah,
that's true.
Themes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it was a Halloween-themed event. Nobody thought that this would really take off. It was a three-night endeavor only. It was October.
Whoa, wait a minute.
Yeah.
It was only three nights?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's it.
Compared to now?
Oh, it was like 2 months almost.
Yep.
Yeah.
It was 1991 right here in Universal Studios, Florida. 1991. And then 6 years later, Universal Studios, Hollywood in 1991. It was just three nights, October 25th, the 26th, and Halloween night, the 31st.
Hmm.
It had one haunted house. The Haunted House.
It's called the Haunted House.
One.
It was called the Dungeon of Terror.
Ooh.
Anyone want to guess how much the admission price was?
Mm. Back then?
35 cents and a poem.
You just had to wear like a ghost costume. You got in for free.
How long was the poem?
It was like a standard haiku about spooky stuff.
So
about
three
a
lines? All right.
That's five is a haiku?
Haiku?
I want to say it was
three.
Like,
no, it's 353, right? Yeah, so you're right.
Or is it 757?
Text us at...
Or is it 575? I don't know.
I thought it was 575.
So, yeah, it's 575.
So any guesses on the ticket price?
Back, let's say $22.
This was 1991.
Yeah.
I was gonna 22. Say $17.98.
$12.95.
About that price. About that price.
$12.95. Now, this did not... The idea of the, let's take our theme park that's billions of dollars. Let's make it spooky for one time of the year. The idea actually started in Universal Studios Hollywood, but here's the caveat. They did it in 1986 for the first time, and they did it in 1992 for the first time. And it was just a simple tram tour. That's all it was.
Oh.
And it just went to like, this happened, whatever, who cares? And they actually had a worker's death kind of mar the entire event. So they didn't touch it again with a 10-foot pole. Universal Studios Florida picked it up in 1991. And the rest, as they say, is history. It was just one house. And this year in 2019, they've got 10, I think.
Yeah,
it seemed
right.
like it.
10.
At least,
yeah,
right?
There
seemed like
there's a bunch.
Everywhere. So much stuff out there.
They've got top tier entertainment. They've got Stranger Things this year. They've got the
Ghostbusters.
Rob Zombie Scare Zone. The Us House. Jordan Peele. They've got it's top notch. But they renamed it from Fright Nights to Universal Studios Florida Halloween Horror Nights in 1992. Guess how many houses they had the next year?
Three.
Two.
They had two.
moving on up. It's
double the amount. It's 100% growth.
Thank you. They had,
well, should they have like 26 by this year?
Yeah, I guess.
You can't they overload the spooky.
So many houses.
They've got, back in 92, they had the Dungeon of Terror. And then they also had the People Under the Stairs.
Oh, I love that movie. Yeah. That's such a good movie.
Yeah, that's
that
good
was
one.
The second year.
Can they do People Under the Stairs again? Because that would be really cool. That would be good. I love that movie. It was so weird.
So Halloween Horror Nights, number one, Fright Nights, back in 1991, was only run for 3 days, October 25th, 26th, and 31st. The next year, how many days, you think?
2 weeks.
2 weeks, so 14 days?
Yes.
Okay.
A fortnight.
A fortnight, if you will.
I'm going to say just a week.
A week, 7 days?
Yes.
Okay.
I feel like they bumped it up to a month.
A month? It was just 5 days.
Oh, not either.
It was October 23rd, 24th, 29th, 30th, and 31st. So immediately, that tells me, hey, look, this thing has legs.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
People will pay good money to get scared. And this all goes back to Ozzy Osbourne in Black Sabbath. He saw everyone queuing in line to see the movie Black Sabbath. And he was like, what's going on? These people are paying money to get scared. And that's where the whole horrorcore genre comes from, things like that. And I thought that was really, really neat. They then expand it. It is a global entity to this day. And that's why I think Halloween Horror Nights is so quintessentially Central Floridian. It is a great idea that caught on, that kind of global phenomenon.
Exactly. Like the idea of Halloween culture and spooky stuff definitely kind of took off in the last, like, whatever, like 10, 15 years, something like that. Like, maybe
it just
became
more mainstream.
Exactly.
In a way.
Yeah. There were people that were always into it. And oh, then yeah. Like, it became more of kind of a, you know, September is also Halloween kind of thing. And now,
sure.
You know, like, people are getting into the fall spirit of spooky type of stuff. So that's cool.
And Halloween has become more of an adult, you know, holiday for so long.
Yeah.
It was
yeah,
more exactly. About children. Now, you know, it's
take
just.
Take it back.
Yeah, we took it back about 20 years ago.
Yeah, no, we're not letting them have that.
Took the scare back.
They have everything. You know what I mean? They have Easter, they have Christmas, all that stuff.
Halloween Horror Nights 6 through 10 basically followed the same formula that was developed pretty much in 1995. It was just 15 nights. And then in 2000, they upped it to 19. They moved it to Islands of Adventure.
I remember that.
They had two instances. So after the September 11th attacks in 2001, they decided to get rid of a lot of the gore. They got rid of a lot of blood, and it was just replaced with a green goop, which I think is an interesting factoid.
Yeah,
that is awesome.
That is very interesting.
Yeah.
We should not do that, and they did not. And then they had this whole entire, what was it? They had this child who was this like ringleader. And this was when it was in Islands of Adventure in 2002. Cindy, sometimes spelled Cindy with an S, so it's Sin.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
That was the daughter of mortuary owner Paul Bearer. But unfortunately...
Wait, Paul the wrestler? Bearer.
I was thinking that too. Yeah, Undertaker's finale.
Yeah. Or Dr. Paul Bearer, who was a old school movie host here in Central Florida.
Oh. That
Dr.
is true
Paul
too.
Bearer.
Yeah. So they ended up abandoning that outright because in 2002 there was a slew of child abductions.
Wow. Okay.
So they decided to scrap that. And I just, yeah. It's
smart.
In the past 27 years, outside of just them deciding to get rid of something they've done since 1992, and that's when, so Bill and Ted was, it started running in 1992, the second year. They ended up scrapping it last year,
yep.
27,
mm-hmm.
Halloween Horror Nights 27.
I think.
That was the final year.
Yeah.
And now they're doing the new movie, so you might want to bring it back.
Yep. Yeah, oh yeah. But it was only like the sideshow thing. It wasn't like a Halloween Horror Nights thing. It was just like a thing, like
a show
at Universal that was like the Bill and Ted show that they stopped doing, right?
So this was Halloween Horror Nights 27. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Well, Bill and Ted, I think, is only a Halloween Horror Nights.
Is it?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, I thought it happens all the time.
No. And it's both. It mostly just goes into like pop culture stuff.
Yeah, whatever happened that year.
News, pop culture, all that.
And that's why it's always timely. Yeah. But outside of that, if you are a small business owner out there listening right now to Fort Fritz on Real Radio 104.1,
let me just say,
this is exactly what you need to do as a small business. You get that one thing you do well, you limit it, you make it only available for a small amount of time, and then you just get as much out of that as you possibly can.
It's the call to action, right? Like, now or never. You do it, you got whatever, a month, the next couple weeks, you show up or it's gone forever. Yep. And that kind of gets people spurred to go, you know.
It's called the Popeye's Chicken Gambit.
And nice. Thank God Halloween Horror Nights is thriving to this point. And also flag up in Orlando, Florida. Like, look, this is how it can be done. One person had an idea probably back then. Nobody wanted to do it, probably. They then decided to do it. It is a global phenomenon. And that is a quintessential, as I said, Central Florida hallmark. Halloween Horror Nights. So excited. And coming up, we have a lot of personal stories. We have gone to Halloween Horror Nights. One of the perks of this job, I gotta say.
Yeah.
Very fun. Load it up.
And yeah, we're gonna tell you all about the best houses, the immaculate scare zones, and also, as I've teased before, turkey legs. You're listening to Fort Fritz right here on Real Radio 104.1. I know you're never coming back. Across the square, across the bridge, across the mills, past the stacks. On a gathering storm comes a tall, handsome man in a dusty black coat with a red right hand.
Fort Fritz on Real Radio 104.1.
Welcome back to Fort Fritz. I am your host, Fritz, joined as always by co-host Man Daddy.
Howdy.
Angela.
Hello.
And Kaz.
Hey.
We are an iHeartRadio station. That means you can just download that absolutely free iHeartRadio app. Search Fort Fritz. You have access to all of our past shows and also the Fort Fritz Campfire Tales, all of our individual stories, easily digestible, as Man Daddy would say. Ooh. And you can just fall in love with us, hopefully.
Not like
just download iHeartRadio app. Angela, Halloween Horror Nights was very exciting.
Yes.
Can you kind of walk us through it?
Well, first of all, we got there at what, 6:30-ish?
About that. Yeah. Sounds right.
That's kind of too late to get there.
Okay, yeah.
It's a bit of a line. It's a bit of a queue.
It's a queue.
So, obviously, we went last night on a Thursday night, and that's close to
Thursday?
The weekend.
Correct.
And the closer you get to the weekend, the busier it's going to get.
Of course.
People are obsessed with this. First of all, you can get a frequent fear pass.
Ooh. Frequent fear pass. Right,
I've got several friends who have that have been going constantly since it started.
Oh, I've had friends that have been going pretty much almost every single night they can with this pass. I mean, to get their money's worth out of it.
Wow.
And I don't know the cost of it, but it's really worth it if this is something you want to do. And people do go all the time.
Yeah, I thought we could do one or two houses a night instead of trying to get
exactly,
all of them.
Exactly. And that's the thing, is that it has become such a phenomenon that it is just, it's packed.
Got some people.
So like I was saying, if you get there at 4:30, that's when people start lining up outside of the park.
Oh, yeah. Man.
And they have the gates closed, and I guess around 5-ish, maybe they start closing down regular studios.
They would have to, right? Because it's a full blown production. Because
it's a completely different ticket to get in for Halloween Horror Nights than it is for the studios throughout the day.
I didn't know that.
And I don't know if you're able to buy, if you go during the day, if there's some deal, if you like stay and you're doing the
just
night.
Hide.
I'm not. I
know. Yeah, just hide
in the mummy. Just
it's kind of spooky also in both.
It works. But people, I mean, it is like a huge, enormous crowd, and it's kind of mayhem. There's a little bit of line systems going on in front of all the ticket queues.
It's so stressful.
But it's crazy. So, but the cool thing is, I think we got there a little too late to see this, is that when they do open the gates for people to come in, they do a whole announcement for people and everyone gets all hyped up to run into the park and everything. And then you can't just run in because you have to get your ticket scanned. But
yeah, they say no running.
Yeah, no, well, no running.
And I think a few years ago when they had the purge zone where they had it set up. So right when everything changed, they set off a siren. There's a
they did, yep.
And
yep.
So the purge is beginning.
Yep.
So,
and they already have the scare actors standing right there.
Right to go.
Like threatening you through that gate. It's pretty great. And you can start to smell the fog as they have all the fog machines going, and you start to hear the music and the chainsaws. By the way, if you've never been.
A lot of chainsaws.
If you've never been to Halloween
Horror
Nights.
No blades on them, but
no blades on them.
But
I
you
will
wouldn't
say
know that.
That.
Sounds like a scary ass chainsaw.
Because not to get too cart before the horse, but just so you know, you don't just go to haunted houses in here. There are scare zones. There are people walking around that will jump in your face. And if you are a girl, they will jump in your face constantly.
Or if you walk behind your significant other and just point down to her because she's already scared, they will scare the hell out of her.
I will say, the more scared you look, the more they're going to go after you.
Because
they want to get the scream out of you. So they go after people they think they're going to get that scream out of. I stare people in the face and I think I make a lot of actors mad because they're like, this one's going to go. And I'm like, No.
My life is way scarier than you, bro.
Yeah.
And then sometimes
you got nothing.
The makeup, I'm like, actually, I think I know that person. Because I do know a
Christina?
People. Yeah.
She's like, don't say my government name. She like runs back into the bushes.
I
had an experience like that at the old school Terra Church Street. When that was
I never was around for that.
Oh, really? It was a pretty cool little place
I've
here.
Heard
it was
really
right there near
stories.
Right there on Church Street. It was a nice little horror thing you go through, and it was year round. And I went there to audition, and so they let me go through the whole maze to check it out for the first time.
Right.
And I knew everyone working there, so anytime someone would jump out, they'd be like, "Oh, everybody's scared." They're like, "Oh, hey, man, daddy!" Just every time, everyone was,
"You're not scaring
dude.
Me anymore."
Yeah.
Pretend like I'm not me.
Yeah. Try.
So what we ended up having to do, because we didn't get there right as they opened and we're standing in line at 4:30. So you do have a couple of big houses like Stranger Things and Ghostbusters, and you know those are going to have enormous lines, right?
Oh, yeah,
which
definitely.
They do. Which I think currently, if you look on the app, which there is a Universal Studios Florida app.
Yeah, tell us more about that because you are a life changer.
That is one of the best
things. The thing helped us so much.
It really did.
I've ever discovered about Halloween Horror Nights. And I actually don't even use it if I go to studios during the day. I mostly use it when I go to Halloween Horror Nights. If you download the app, just go to the little menu tab. They actually do have Halloween Horror Nights as a whole specific part of the app. They have all the houses broken down, the wait times, which houses they are, descriptions of each house. There's a whole map that shows where everything is.
Is it just Halloween Horror Nights, like the app?
It's Universal Studios
or Universal Florida app.
Nice.
It has all the dining that's open, which the whole drive-in, they take the R and the V out, so it says die-in.
That's the kind of stuff I live for.
Yeah.
I live for that just,
those little details.
Oh, they're so good with that.
So what I can suggest to you, if you do not get there and you're at the front of the line to get into the park,
pay attention now, people.
Run, look at your map. Go to the houses in the back of the park.
Haul ass.
The smaller houses. They're going to have the shorter lines, and you're probably going to be able to do all of them within like the first 15, 20 minutes.
Ooh, all right.
And you're also going to be with the real heads, the people who are like, that's what's up.
Yes,
yeah,
exactly. And you're getting the scare actors like fresh. So they're like, they're insane. They're
just
like ready
you
to get.
Past them. They're like, hey, I want to scare
been,
you.
Like pumping themselves up. They are ready for people to walk through. They haven't been like screaming at people all night. They are like ready for you.
They're like, boo, boo.
But what's great too,
dear lozenge,
is that one of the things that you got to do when you go to these, because every haunted house not only has people in it that are coming out and it has all the sound effects and everything, the details of these houses are amazing.
It's so spectacular.
And sometimes you're moving so quickly, you don't get the time to actually look.
And
you
that's
know?
One of those things too.
I'm guilty of that too.
That, yeah.
I want to just get out and so everyone else behind me can really enjoy it. And I go, well, hell, I didn't enjoy that.
Yeah, he was running through them. I need to really take my time.
I, unfortunately, the first time I go through, am looking for the holes of where someone's going to pop out at you. So
yeah.
I lose the looking at the details of the house because I'm too like, oh, there's a dark corner. Or you see something happen up ahead. But try not to do that because you're kind of ruining it for yourself.
Yep.
Try to experience it as it's happening to you because that's the way it's designed to be.
Mm-hmm.
They do kind of rush you through, but that happens more later in the evening when they just really want to get people through. In the beginning of the night, you're able to kind of take your time, which I think we were able to do. So
yeah, absolutely.
Didn't feel rushed at all.
No, we had a great time. Also, just like walking around those scare zones, as you said, Angela.
Picking up on the nuance of all the little, like you said, the details that they got like strung up and little things people are doing. It was spectacular.
And also people watching. You can't put a price on that. Because
so everyone's like getting costumes and stuff. It's like not even Halloween for like another couple of weeks. So like yep. You know, going
you out see there, people just losing their minds, almost peeing their pants. They're so scared. Oh. And you're just like, that's funny.
It's the best. And people will legit run away.
Yeah.
Like run away. They get so scared. It's the best.
That, for a scare actor, that's the golden achievement right there.
Top of the mountain.
You know, if you get someone to run actually away from you, it's like, here's a point.
And just a little inside information, too. People who are hired as scare actors, they do these auditions in, like, June or July.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's during the summer.
And even if you've done it before, you audition every single time. Every single time.
And they own re-audition. You.
Yeah.
They own you for those 2 months.
But it's really cool. You get to show up at, like, 3, someone does your makeup, and then...
A really, really great point on that, Angela, is that Karina, and you can hear her
Karina.
Here on the weekends, yes. Real Radio 104.1. She's the show right after mine, which is 3 to 7. So she's 7 to 10 sometimes. Wherever we need her, she pops in. She was La Llorona a couple of years
ago. Oh, really?
Oh, no way. Nice.
Yes.
That's a common thread for a while now.
Yep. And she loves it. She's got so many great stories. We need to have her on.
We should. I love Karina.
I love Karina.
I wonder, I think she won. Because you can, as scare actors, they won awards. Like, scare actor of the night. You're the scare actor of this
Who's
season.
Who's the judge for that? Like, someone's walking around.
God. People walk around. They constantly have people. God. The God of
Would it be the devil?
Anyway. They work together on this
Yeah,
one.
Obviously. They, like, yeah.
Two sides of the same
coin. It's devilishly good.
Yeah.
You know, you get the best scares out of constantly really like going for it every single time. Because think about it. You're doing the same track, repeating the same thing over and over again.
That are written for you.
And you have to give your all every single time. You can't just let that. Yeah.
Like, sup?
You're checking Twitter.
That energy scaring people has to be there. Every single time, and I don't know how many times you pop out.
They should just staff it with dads. Like, dads are like, dads are always like hiding around corners, pop out
dads.
And scare you and stuff. It should just be all dads. Like, it should just be.
What dad did you
this
have?
Year at Halloween,
a scary dad.
Dads.
They would always pop out around stuff and like try to like scare me. So, yeah.
A scary dad comes around the corner and goes, I'm completely dead inside. Oh, no.
I don't know how to make rent this month. Oh, no.
Did you say you're completely dad inside?
He
or
did.
Dead? Oh, nice.
As a dad joke.
Dad joke.
Nice.
Oh, man.
Dad joke.
I thought as a pun, Angela, you would appreciate that.
Oh, it was so good.
Thank you.
I was glad that I heard that correctly.
Thank you, because you hate my puns.
I love your
as
puns.
She
I
should.
Love all puns. I know we're going to talk about the houses, but I have to say one of my favorite things, though, is the Academy of Villains, their dance group. They're insane.
You've been talking about
it. Was really spectacular.
They
are
kind of insane. Some of the people on that show, they look like crazy people.
Let me just say this. For the past 3 years, you have been talking about the Academy of Villains.
It's one of the best things
It was really
ever.
Cool. It was really cool. I didn't expect it to be as cool as it was.
Thank you, Kaz, because this was the first time I saw this, and I was blown away. I totally get why you love them so much.
They're incredible.
And you've always wanted to be a part of that show, right?
Oh, my gosh. So
if there's anyone listening.
There were 2 years that they were on the smaller stage, and the first time I saw them, and they do some shadow puppetry, they have pyrotechnics, the people that are in this, they do like hip hop and what else do they do in there?
They do a mix of everything.
They do kind of a mix of everything. They use a lot of pop music that you're going to end like cool remixes of everything. And the first year they did this Insane Asylum show. The second year, gosh, I forget what it was, but they had this dance off and I was so bummed because I didn't know they were doing it. And I wanted to be up on there so bad and do that dance off.
You were hurt.
I was. And the friend I was
so
with.
So your seat like doing like
she was
the
like,
moves, like
I didn't know that you would want to do that. I would have told you ahead of time that they do that so you could have been prepped. Like, oh my God, I was so bummed. And then last year.
I should have told you. Yes, you should have told me.
Yes, you should have told me. Like, I think I spent the rest of that night just like, I feel like I missed my chance.
Oh.
And that's the Academy of Villains?
Academy of Villains, their dance group. And then last year, because no more Bill and Ted, they actually moved them to the bigger stage.
Oh, to the big game.
So they took over the Bill and Ted stage.
That was the Bill and Ted stage.
Okay. So, and I have to say the first... Last year when they did on that first time on that stage, it kind of took the intimacy away. I loved them being on that smaller stage. Mm. But this year
they sold out.
This, I kind of felt like that a little bit, where you're like, oh, kind of part of the, because the that second year that they did at the smaller stage, they got on stage by like entering through the crowd and touching people, mm-hmm. and made it very immersive and Green bringing Day's people not... up on stage and everything.
Yep.
But this year, I feel like they found that nice middle ground of feeling intimate and immersed with everybody. So they figured out how to bring that onto that bigger stage again.
It was spectacular.
It was.
They're insane. Like most people, when you're like, I really want to see this dance show. And we're like, oh.
No. It dance was show. Totally worth it. Totally go see that.
But you know me.
Yeah. Just physically dominating and captivating.
Yeah.
And it technical prowess.
Yeah.
Hit the notes of the night.
Well, that's what Halloween Horror Nights is about. It's about the immersion. Yeah. It's about how much it takes you into everything, whether it be the scare zones, whether it be the houses, that when you're there, you're in it. They do such good with the detail, with the, like you talked about last week, with the sight lines, where when you get into a certain area where all you can see is what you see, that you are literally immersed in it. And that's what Halloween Horror Nights does better than anybody.
Yes.
I didn't say this last week, but the thing that just excites me to no end is knowing that the engineers of a specific location pre-planned and then engineered and produced take a couple of steps and then the entire world around you is gone.
Yep.
Even looking back, it's gone. And that's what I love the most about these kind of theme park things, and especially Halloween Horror Nights.
Well, they do a beautiful job with that. You walk into those houses, and some of them they've just kind of built in certain areas, and some of them are actually on their sound stages. And you don't know which way you're going, which way you're walking through these houses, and you come out the other end. You're totally disoriented. Like, wait, the entrance is over there. Where am I right now?
What's going on?
Yeah, they
immersion.
Immersion.
You're lost.
Immersion.
Yeah, it's great.
Well, coming up, we're gonna go into the actual houses. We are going to give you
our picks.
A die by the sword Fort Fritz review of as many houses as we saw. So get ready. Strap in right now if you want to. Make yourself another drink if you're listening at home. How fun.
We'll drink
Halloween
coffee
Horror
or water.
Is. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, you can drink liquids, I guess.
Milk.
You are listening to
Soda.
Rural Radio 104.1.
Fritz on Real Radio 104.1.
Who is this irresistible creature who has an insatiable love for the dead?
Hi, welcome back to Fort Fritz here on Real Radio 104.1.
That's a hard F.
Thank you. I am your co-host, Man Daddy. Right over there is Fritz.
Hey, Man Daddy.
Right over there is Kaz.
Hey, Man Daddy.
Right over there is Angela.
Hey, Man Daddy.
We're talking about Halloween Horror Nights and our experience there and what you can experience by going to see Halloween Horror Nights. What I'd like to say is one of my favorite things is just because being a metalhead and a horror fan, having the Rob Zombie scare zone, the Hillbilly Deluxe,
that was definitely
and the House of a Thousand Corpses house was just so awesome. You get to see Dragula.
You got to actually see the Dragula.
You get to see
and
the Dragula.
And I didn't realize that it was because it's like a drag racer, like Dragula. I thought it was Dracula and drag. That's what I always thought, like Dragula. Like it's not. It's a car.
Yeah, it's awesome. And,
which is cool.
And since it's Rob Zombie, you expect someone would run up to you every 5 seconds and go, yeah!
I thought I was hearing it from the bushes. Different cadence.
What am I?
Actually, I feel like Man Daddy was doing that through the house the whole time.
I can't help myself. Like, every time
throwing off the scare action. Like, wait, that's my part.
I kept hearing him just say, yeah. And I would look at him like, what? Did I ask it? But one of my favorite memes of all time is the cartoon Rob Zombie with this, like, you know, his like corpse bride in the actual Dracula. And it's like, this could be us, but you won't dig through the ditches
and burn through the witches.
So seeing Dracula in my mind, I was like, yeah. All day, babe.
It's pretty
all
cool.
Day, I will.
I had a trivia team the other night that their name is actually a great idea. It was Rob Zombie Laundry Day. what does it look like on Rob Zombie? What, does he wear a suit? Is he wearing a tux? Because Rob Zombie always looks like it's a laundry day. So on a Rob Zombie laundry day, what is he wearing?
You
what does he wear?
You can't pigeonhole Rob Zombie.
The yes, man, you can. That's what he does.
Rob Zombie started off as a band in 1986 in New York City.
What Zombie?
Their first album was 1992's or 1991's La Sexorcisto. And then in 95... Astro Zombie 2000.
Yeah.
It's just amazing. And like, he had the longest road to get to where he is right now, and he's celebrated.
And the man is prolific. He got to make movies, he got to make several albums, and got,
I have so much respect for that.
That whole area was super cool. Very well done. Again, same thing. The immersion, the details, fantastic.
Yeah, they really, if you're a fan of House of Thousand Corpses, you're going to love the House of Thousand Corpses house.
Who isn't?
I haven't seen it, so, well, I didn't know what was going on.
Well, you borrowed my DVD.
Yeah. By the way, I think he would wear a muumuu on laundry day. Just throwing that
out
there. Yeah, I can see that too. I can see that too.
A zombie muumuu.
With a tam.
Cast tip.
Yeah.
If you're at laundry day and there are no pants available, take your t-shirt, flip it upside down, legs through the sleeve holes, tie it toga style.
Wait a minute. But what about
how thin are your legs?
About the neck hole? What's going on?
It's dangling. It's like, it looks like a kind of a, you know, it's like a toga thing. Yeah, it's an air. It's laundry day. What do you want from me?
There are no rules on laundry day.
Oh my
Angela.
God! Like
shirts is pants on laundry day. All right, cast it.
It's like a porthole.
Yeah,
it's like porthole.
You tie it off if you're a prude, I guess, or whatever. You just let it go.
There ain't nothing wrong with that. So that the Rob Zombie scare zone, I thought was
Hellbilly
absolutely
Deluxe.
So cool. Yeah, Hellbilly Deluxe. You see all of his different characters and
the guy with the big gray head. That guy.
And also
that was Rob Zombie.
There, maybe the other day it was.
There
know.
Is a there's also a House of a Thousand Corpses house.
Yep.
So what? I have nothing else to do.
That's it.
He's Rob Zombie right now.
Yep.
I thought that was really cool. Again, Kaz was a little, he didn't know what was going on, but that's okay because some movie houses like Us, and we will get to that later, but
Us was fantastic. The one that I really liked was Killer Clowns from Outer Space, because that, that movie as a kid, I knew it was supposed to be, and now as an adult, I know it's supposed to be tongue in cheek and it was kind of like this like campy kind of thing. But as a kid, I was like, no, like this is like the scariest thing of all time.
Oh, the cotton candy blood sacks.
And they're like, cocooned up. It was like, it was one of the most terrifying movies.
I've never saw it.
Oh, you've never seen Killer Clowns from Outer Space?
So the house is extremely disturbing to me.
Right. And it's scary as hell.
Yeah. And I didn't see that movie. So it works whether you've seen it or not.
It was gnarly.
I think that movie came out in like 1985 or 84, but, to go back to what Angela said, House of a Thousand Corpses is one of the back lot houses.
Yeah, so run.
You get there.
Run to the corpses.
Run
get there
through
as
the
soon.
And
yeah, burn all the witches.
Yeah.
Through the scare.
Dracula!
And then Dracula,
And sing an entire Rob Zombie song as you're running to the
so they know that you mean business. That was going to even try to scare you. They're just going to know. Get out of this man's way.
This guy's serious. Get out of the way.
In that tempo. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Just haul ass. But yeah, House of a Thousand Corpses was great. It was movie accurate. Really, really good. And get there as soon as you get there. Do not wait. Get there. Start your night in the back of the lot. And that's all I'll say.
See, I got disoriented. I didn't know where Killer Clowns was when we were kind of walking around.
Because they're all Killer Clowns.
Yeah, we're just like walking around and stuff. Yeah. But that one really struck me because, again, it was like similar to, what was the one with the puppets? Puppet Master.
Puppet Master.
So, which is not a...
Do you have a favorite puppet? Everyone has to have a favorite puppet.
I don't know their names. No. The one that looks like a little priest?
It's been so long.
Oh, Blade, the one with the hat and the little preacher? Metal face. So he has
that
the hook.
That might have been him,
Yeah, that's Blade. I love him.
So, in that same vein of these like old 80s movies that just like really terrified me as a kid, Killer Clowns is one of those. And it was just same production studio that did Killer Clowns and Puppet Master?
No, Full Moon, I think, was just Puppet Master.
Okay. Yeah.
Worth the wait, by the way. And also, throughout the night, it was getting below 30-minute wait time. So, it's one of those that people are kind of sleeping on. Killer Clowns.
Oh, yeah.
You can totally hit it up at any time of the night.
More, exactly. I don't know if it was like for the old heads or whatever, but it was one of those things I was like, we got to go see that because I'm really into that. And it was like great. Really weird.
It's probably also not that big because a lot of people have fear of clowns.
There's a clown thing.
Chlorophobia.
Yeah. Like
Thank
people
you.
Have
Points.
Phobias. So That's some people point. Avoid that kind of stuff because they really do freak out. Because
they're scary. They're scary. Like clowns are terrifying.
Just trying to make it laugh.
This.
It's interesting that they got the Killer Clowns license and not the Pennywise It license for this year, wow. Which would have been way more gnarly. But like, for a haunted house kind of vibe, this seems like more what you wanted out of that.
Put all the money into Stranger Things and Ghostbusters.
I would agree.
Stranger Things.
I would agree. Which, Angela, you love that house.
That now the house last year they did season one.
Oh, so there was Stranger Things last year too?
Yep.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
It was huge.
Because this one seemed to be more based on like the more recent seasons, right?
They didn't really. Yes, this one's 2 and 3.
Right, okay.
Last year, they did really beautiful things of like the Demogorgon coming through the wall.
Oh, and what's that thing? That's the creature?
Yes, that's the scary creature.
Oh, I don't like that.
And you know what was interesting about it? That was the scariest part about it. But then some of the stuff that would scare you was just because people would pop out, but they weren't really doing scary things. Like, it would just be like Will.
It's just Will Byers, like,
man. Yeah, like, people just going like, Will. Like,
you are creepy.
Screaming.
You're not even, you're not makeup on. You're just like, got a little bowl cut. That's weird.
And now he's going to have those weird long legs, you know?
Lots and lots of really tiny Universal women dressed up like boys. Like,
yeah.
Boys.
Oh, yeah.
But they didn't
What was that? What the hell?
Oh, yeah. He loved it.
What the hell was that?
Yeah.
Rob Zombie. Yeah, that. Dear God. All
What's
right.
What's going
let's,
on, man?
Let's move on.
Halloween Horror, the Texan server, 77031, powered by Sutherland Nissan. They love this, by
Dear
the way.
God.
Please go out. Have fun at Halloween Horror Nights presented by Universal Studios Orlando.
I honestly don't really want to talk too much about the details of this year's Stranger Things, but they did a beautiful job with it.
Very cool.
But last year was really neat because they had Hopper standing around. That was the thing. It was like, Hopper's not a bad person, but they would just have him menacingly like walking around. You're like, well, that's not scary.
I want to hang out with Hopper.
Hopper's my like totem. He saved me from this.
But he seems like a cool dude you want to drink a beer with.
But the details were good, and all the stuff with the Demogorgon was good, and all the stuff within like the Hawkins lab stuff was really good. So
now it's all about the mind flare.
Yeah.
I don't think that house ever got under an hour.
No.
Wait. And that, okay.
Never.
So I get it. It's, I think, probably the longest house we went through.
Yeah.
It seemed like the longest one.
It is.
That's
it
the
is
centerpiece.
The
that's yeah. the jewel in the crown.
That seems like.
And worthwhile.
Yeah. I'll be honest Absolutely with you, folks. If you're listening right now to Fort Fritz on Real Radio 104.1, you got to get there. Early as hell.
And
and set up shop. Or
yes.
You got to go there way late.
Yeah, yep, that's there are a certain group of people that they say it's better to get there late when people are leaving out, and that way you can, you know, hit it all quick near the end. So it depends on what, if you're looking to go for the whole long
then
experience.
Hopper's actually
everything.
Trying to help you. He's like, come on, get through. Come on, no, I got to go. I got to go home. I got to feed the cats.
Let's go. Yeah. Sorry, that's what Hopper says in the first season. Anyway.
Yeah, he does, yeah.
Yeah, if you're someone who is standing at the gate before it opens at like 4:30, run to the Stranger Things house. If you're walking in the park, wait till like 1 a.m. Yeah. to go to Stranger Things.
You are already lost on that train. Yep. If you are just taking your time, go ahead and take your time. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
You know what? Let's talk about a sleeper, because I think one of the most amazing things that was just an absolute sleeper was Yeti House.
Yeah, not enough Yeti. Not enough talk about the Yeti, man.
Yeti House.
Bad. Yeti House is fine.
It was okay.
Good.
It was really effective. Again, low amount of weight. You can walk on at any time, and it's an original content.
I really like the Anarcade.
Anarcade was great. So was explain
weird,
that one.
It was the weird where they have the kind of the big arcade cabinets where you kind of feel like you're a little kid walking through this like arcade, this
how cool
dark
is
arcade.
That, right?
It was cool, and like I didn't understand how they were going to kind of make it spooky, but it was, and it brought back the nostalgia of kind of 80s arcade feel, and that, you know what, I feel like old arcades kind of smell like a foggy haunted house. So it kind of
arcades did you go to?
Maybe the spooky ones. Exactly.
In the middle of nowhere in a parking lot. Yeah.
I thought it was really cool. It was a good idea. Unique.
So did that hit you as a gamer who has grown up loving the games, like as a little kid, looking up to the big screens?
Exactly.
Because that's what I got.
It gave you that old school feeling of like, oh man, what is that? But like, you can't really interact with any of them. So it's not like you can like play any of the stuff, but it was. It gave you that feel of being in this kind of like spooky kind of, you know, alternative universe arcade as a child or whatever. It was cool.
There's too much to see. That's what they're saying.
Yeah.
There is too. The chances are you're not going to see everything because there is so much to see. You want to go once, twice, three times, four times.
Absolutely.
Because there is so much to see.
It's like visual sound overload when you're there.
And,
it is.
And again, who came up with this idea.
Exactly. Such
Orlando,
good idea.
Florida. This one idea spread like wildfire all over the globe, and we have the opportunity in our backyard on a Thursday night.
Exactly.
Check
just
it out.
Just to go and get scared.
It's so cool. Oh, it's so cool. Also, Us. Us by Jordan Peele. That house is so good.
See the movie. Definitely see the movie so you can understand the whole psychological twist they have going on here. You can't spoil anything. Can't
absolutely.
Spoil it.
It's absolutely.
Just, no spoilers.
And just Jordan Peele, he is the new, you know, master of nouveau horror in a way. You know, he's really, or at least psychological thrillers, if you will.
Thank you. I
and
was so, gonna, yes.
Really interested to see where you, and with Us, it's a very personal scare. It's a very personal right. scare, and that's one of the things that it's about. So that's where, see the movie.
How so?
Because it's Us. It's not
yeah,
them.
That's
it's
true.
Us.
Yeah.
Us. Yeah, it's
you
not
can't
them. It's
talk
us.
About it without ruining it.
Right. Yeah.
I wonder.
Yeah.
In Spanish, is it Nosotros? It's Nosotros. Like,
Nosotros.
It's called Nosotros in Spanish.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that.
For sure.
Not just Nosotros.
You just, you don't mess with me, man. You shared a turkey leg together.
That's true.
It's true, but then that would be the last. Aww. That'll be the last.
By the way, yeah, Angela, now. Angela, you took that photo of them sharing the turkey leg together.
Oh, I have
right?
that.
Yeah, please send it to me. I'm going to post it right
now. Great. I'm so greasy.
I sent it to everyone.
I'm still getting flecks of it out of it my beard.
I'm trying to figure out which Instagram filter looks best on it.
What? Because none of them work, right?
Turkey noir. Noir.
Turkey noir.
You guys look so
Trip
happy. There are so many houses that we could be talking about.
Ghostbusters.
You
didn't even mention Ghostbusters.
It's just so perfect. It's just, like, it looks it's like being in the damn movie.
Stranger Things was so good, but we have not actually really tapped into the Ghostbusters because I love Ghostbusters.
Who does?
So cool.
Who doesn't? I mean,
it's nostalgia.
Yes.
You got your Gozer. You got your Stay Puff. It's all there.
It's
all there.
Good.
Slimer.
It's so
Slimer,
nostalgic.
Of course.
And it wasn't even really scary. It was just cool.
You can quote the. You know what line is coming up. You can quote the entire movie while you're
very
watching.
Well done.
It's very,
very,
very
well
cool.
done.
In addition to that, you have, let's see, Depths of Fear. You have Graveyard Games. You have the Universal Classic Monsters, and
which I thought was pretty cool.
Frankenstein, Creature of the Black Lagoon.
Yeah, classics. Yeah. Bring back
Phantom
basics.
Of the Opera. Hunchback of Notre Dame, the Mummy.
Which I didn't understand why they were going to make him
right
a scary character.
That's kind of
he's like
mean.
A tragic. He's
it's
like a tragic,
so
ant, like
that's
a hero.
Kind of mean.
Like, exactly. Just because he's ugly and he's got a hunchback, he's a scary character.
That was
all of a sudden.
Maybe the disturbing thing.
Yeah.
For me.
It was a little
I
bit
really,
kind of meh. Yeah. I kind of want to put my arm around him. Like, it's okay, dude. Like, you're not.
Like,
you're not
take
scary.
Him out with you.
Exactly. Like, come with us to Ghostbusters. This is cooler. Like, don't worry about this.
But he was mad scary.
Quasimodo, we got your back. All of it. And there's a lot of it.
Come on. See, back.
That was a good. That was a good.
I didn't even need it when
on
I started
the hunchback.
It.
Damn.
There
I have a hunch this is a bad idea.
There are so many great areas. So many great areas. You got Vanity Ball. You've got Vikings Undead. And
Vanity
also Zombieland.
Undead Vikings. You can't stop Undead Vikings.
I actually really liked Vanity Ball.
Vanity Ball seems
cool.
It was cool.
They
plastic
also want to
surgery,
talk about
like Vanity,
crazy,
look,
crazy
the way
yes.
you look. Theater
you know what it
stuff.
Reminded me of the scene in Escape from L.A. with Bruce Campbell, where they had the weird underground, like we were trying to make
ooh,
everyone like very beautiful,
nice.
And they all had like very like weird distended like. You
I
know.
Love the aesthetic of it. It was really weird and
it's cool,
surreal, and
you see someone bandaged up the entire time. And you're like, ooh, this isn't gonna end.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh god, no.
Do you remember the TV show The Swan? The reality TV show The Swan.
Ooh, I remember that.
Where they take normal looking people, quote unquote.
Is that still
and they
around?
Would just wreck,
or is that,
oh god, no. This
no.
Is good, no.
Yeah.
And they would wreck
just,
their face.
No, they would. They would
no,
wreck
they
them with
would.
Like they would give them the worst plastic surgery. Like when normally you'd have like one plastic surgery a year. They'd give them 52 in like 1 month.
What?
And they would just
awful.
Wreck them, and then they'd have a big reveal like how beautiful they were.
Yeah.
And then at the end
ooh.
Of the show, one of them still. Wasn't beautiful enough of blues. That was my favorite thing. It's like you just went through all this, but that, still not pretty
that
enough. Sorry.
Terrifying.
So we had an absolute blast at Halloween.
Amazing. Spectacular.
2019. Again, absolutely a blast. Universal Studios. Let's give a little round of applause.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys very much. And I do want to say, I do appreciate very much going, but I also want to suggest if you can swing it, do the RAP tour.
Yes.
Oh, that looks super cool.
You got the scratch.
Yes, because
it's a little bit more money.
You have to pay for the ticket for Halloween Horror Nights, and then on top of that, you have to pay for that tour. And it's like, what, 10 to 12 people, I think, in a group, maybe 10 to 20 or so. You get your own individual guide. They walk you through each house. They tell you a bunch of background on each house. You do get like a special place where you eat. That person will stop and make sure you get like drink breaks. You can go on rides. Yep. And let's not forget, too, there are rides open. So the rides at studios are actually open.
Absolutely
they put
stunning.
These together like movie sets, like theater sets. I mean, these are that's what
it was amazing.
The detail's incredible.
And it all started on a backlot, Orlando, Halloween Horror Nights. God, I mean, hats off. It is one of the best cultural attractions you can go to in Florida every year. And thank you again, Universal Studios.
Woo.
We had an absolute blast. Coming up next, Bungalower and the Bus. You are listening to Fort Fritz on Real Radio 104.1.
Until next time, pleasant dreams.